Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. More Pianta Village! Because it's the last level of the game, or I should say last main level of the game, actually. After Pianta Village, this game's gonna go pretty dang quick, I have to say. Well, anyway, episode 5 is the secret of the village Underside, and it's another beautiful night stage. We have to go down there with Yoshi, as implied by that little shot with the egg, and then, you know, the shot to the village Underside, as I showed before when I was down there with the Goopy Inferno in the last episode. Anyway, it wants that through. Oh boy! Those wind guys only appear in the night stages, may I add. I don't think they appear in any other one. I'll probably be proven wrong when I see them in a later stage. But yeah, they're only around that bridge anyway, so they're not really that much of a problem. What is wrong with me? I can't climb vertically now? Anyway, in this tree is every single fruit that you could possibly want. Grab the one that Yoshi wants and take it over to him. Whichever one he needs is in that tree. I don't really know if he ever picks a durian. I don't remember him ever picking a durian, because I don't think that they want you to do that with this border around the whole village, because you see how this is? In order to get a durian over this border, you would have to dive at it, and what happens when you dive at a durian is that it really flies far, and then you lose control of the durian, and it would probably go off the cliff, and that would be pretty frustrating, and in turn, pretty bad game design. Anyway, look out for the wind guys. Well, they harass you a little bit, but that's okay. So, just go down here with your Yoshi friend. What the heck happened there? Did you see that? Here you go, you smelly critter. There! Now, we're gonna go back under here. This time, we're gonna try jumping down onto it from here, like so, instead of from up above. I don't know what the heck happened there. It was like Yoshi got caught on the edge of the mushroom like that. Wow. Weird. Well, Yoshi wants a pineapple this time, so let's give it to him. And there's Yoshi back from his rehabilitation egg. So let's jump back down to the mushroom obstacle course of sorts down here, and carefully navigate our way through here with his hover jump. Hopefully I'll be able to make it this time. Evidently my platforming skills have degraded somehow between last part and this part, even though I didn't stop filming since the last part. All I did was stop the camera. So anyway, you go over to here and continue on this path, and holy cow, that was a scary camera angle. And I'm going to use the spin jump to get up to here, and it's 2 1-ups. On these very small mushrooms. Well, these aren't that small, but still, they're kind of small for 3D platforming standards. Anyway, you vomit on this force field-like thing and jump down into the mushroom cap. Mario gets mugged once again. Unbelievable. You'd think he'd have a stronger grip on things. Oh, this one. This one is the bane of my existence. Okay, see these guys here? These are all Chucksters. Talk to them and they'll be like, "Howdy, I'm a Chuckster! You better be careful in speaking to powerful Pianta. Some will chuck you straight up, but most will chuck you backwards. When it comes to tossing folk, I'm well a Chuckster! Oh boy!" And the tricky part of this is to get them to throw you to the correct direction. Now, what you want to do to get... So kind of visualize this as good as possible. You can practice with this guy here. Like, I'm going to aim for this 1-up. Align the camera with yourself, the guy, and the 1-up, and then talk to the guy. And then what will happen is that he'll fling you in that direction. He always flings you in the opposite direction that you talk to him. So lining up the camera will really help you visualize your shot, and hopefully will prevent you from dying. Hello, pink guy. And there we go. So, now what you want to do with this one here, there's two guys. Both these can take you to the other side, but for the smaller guy, you want to aim him over to that right side where there's the border, and... No! That was so close! Alright, let's try this again. I got the 1-up back at the beginning there, so if I ever, you know, die, I'm just gonna continuously get that 1-up to keep my lives up. So, yeah, you get the idea. Oh no, he's too far away now. But yeah, the smaller guy is easier to control than the bigger guy, because you have to get the bigger guy, like, in the middle of his walk. like somewhere around here or so, you would have to talk to him to get him to throw, to not overthrow you, excuse me. And let's try this again. And this one looks like it's going to be successful. Okay, now this one, he's going to throw you upwards like that. So you want to align the camera like so. It's slightly to the right. So angle yourself just like that. And higher, higher! Woo! And we're okay. Whoa. Oh, now you've got these guys that are going to be in your way. They keep respawning from those painted spots on the walls there. Best thing that you can do is kill off the ones that are in front of him. And then just talk to him quickly. You know, align your shot quickly. And this should do it, I hope. Looks very good. And now this last one is the most tricky one, because you have to get him to go to the left over there to get to that platform while he's walking around in a circle like this. So you have to get him while he's walking sideways. The best way to do this is to use this center line here and line yourself up with the guy. Like when the center of his body passes over that line, immediately talk to him. And then hope that he throws you onto the platform. So here we go. Wait, what the heck? He stopped in the middle. Oh wait, I think that's wrong. Go! Oh, I made it anyway! Oh, well there's your shine. That one's nerve-wracking. Next one, and it's gonna be another quick shine. Episode 6, Piantas in Need. In this one, there's a bunch of Piantas, and they're covered with that lava goop stuff. So you've gotta free them and wash off the lava goop to save them all, and this guy's, the mayor here, is gonna be in a panic. Oh no, I went away for just a bit, now look! I can't believe it, I'm not right, I'm listening to Timothy! Some of the villagers dropped the murder! And he's all in a complete and total panic just like that, and he sounds exactly like that with that tone of voice, as well as that pitch. So yeah, you gotta rescue 10 villagers in the span of 3 minutes. This is ridiculously easy to do, even if you don't know where they are. You know, as long as you know the layout of the village, so to speak. Anyway, there's one over here. So free him, wash him off. It's actually a kid, so it's actually a girl, so it's not a him. I apologize, little girl, I didn't mean to say that. And there's number 2. And there's 2 right here. You're gonna have to come back to the stage in a later episode, because some of these give you blue coins. Some of these people give you blue coins, excuse me. So, yeah, there's another one here. And just clean her off. There you go. Don't even bother talking to them, you'll save a lot more time. Well, actually, the clock stops after you talk to them anyway, so what am I talking about? So I guess you could talk to them if you wanted to, but when you do talk to them, some of them will give you blue coins, and yeah, I don't want to accidentally collect the blue coin. That's partly why I don't want to talk to them. So yeah, you get the idea. So let's clean off. No, don't you dare try and attack me. Well, you did attack me, but you kind of failed at that. Okay, there should be another one here. So come on, there you go. And clean, and another one over here. This will be number 9. Look how much time I still have left over here. There's only one left, and that's just along this path. All you have to do is follow this path until you get to the back of the village here. And sure enough, here's the last one. And after you talk to the last one, you have to go back to the start. Or I should say, after you wash the last one, you have to go to the start and talk to the mayor. They don't immediately give you the shine sprite like they usually do after you complete the task at hand, which is kind of strange, actually, but I guess it's different. It's not that hard to go back to the beginning, obviously, because, you know, there's nothing to bug you. And so, here we go. There's the mayor. Let's talk to him. And see that? There's no wind gust enemies there bugging you, so that's why I think they're only at night. Or at least that's what they seem to be. Remember that I said that they seem to only come out at night? I don't know why, but that's just what they seem like. Anyway, grab your shine, and I'll see you at the next shine. Another ridiculously easy shine and quick shine is Shadow Mario Runs Wild. Oh, and I also should mention something. After you do this one, there's going to be a special event going on in Delfino Plaza. After you defeat, well, never mind. I'll show it once I get there. I don't want to spoil things. So it's a traditional Shadow Mario battle, and you have to spray him with water. But this is a little different. This time he's painting as he's going with this lava paint, and you can't get coins from this paint, so it does kind of get in your way. But as long as you continuously spray forward, it's not even going to affect you whatsoever. And since this place is so wide open, it doesn't really do all that much. Oh, that lava paint does create those wind gust guys. It makes them pop up for whatever reason. But they don't really get in your way either. And look at that, it's already over! And anyway, after you collect the shine, or I should say, after you collect the 7th shine of each level, all the Shadow Mario ones, basically, an event will happen in Delfino Plaza. And this event is known as the Flood. No, not F-L-U-D-D, it's F-L-O-O-D. Again, he's not affected by water. What the poop is that? And as you can see, the whole place is freaking flooded. Well, in order to stop this flood, you can either go up to Corona Mountain over there, which is what you're supposed to do to cancel out this flood, or go into a level like Serena Beach or Pianta Village. What, can you go into Pianta Village? I'm not sure. But anyway, I would like to show off a little glitch here that involves this log here. Now, you know this whole place is flooded. This place looks very neat flooded, I have to say. Maybe it's because it's very different. I don't know, it's kind of silly looking. But anyway, you try to swim up through this log here. And, come on. This may take you a few tries to get. Just give it a couple shots. I don't know if this... I think it was fixed in later versions of the game. There you go! Did you see that? It just, like, pushes you underwater, and then you're walking underwater as if you're on dry land. Look at this. You've got the effect, like, this is underwater dust, like you're kicking up dust while swimming against the ocean floor. I mean, the floor of this river here. This is the ocean over here, so I guess you could consider that to be the ocean as well. But you never run out of air here. It's basically treated as if you were above the surface of the water. You can stay down here for as long as you'd like, and you can even access this after the flood is over, after the logs are gone, which I'll show you after I explore this area, after this, you know, I gotta explore this area as long as I'm taking advantage of this flood here. So, yeah, this is a very, very silly glitch here, but it's also very cool to exploit, because you see, it acts like you're above land, but it's got the effects like you're underwater. You can even look through here. It looks like you're looking at the surface of the water, but that's actually just the texture of the water that you can see from both sides. So, yeah, that has absolutely no effect. And also, you don't absorb the water when you're underwater, so you can actually run out of water in here. But that's okay. If you ever run out of... I shouldn't say... If you ever run out of water, just go up to the surface. You can easily climb up the surface by going over to here and going above it just like that. And see that? Now, why that glitch works is because you trick the game into thinking that you don't touch the surface of the water. The surface of the water is like the water tension separating you from your swimming physics to your normal physics. Okay, now what you want to do is... by the way, a lot of the Piantas are on the roof here, and he was lucky if you could follow the current, yeah. And might I add that that guy that was on that island over there, remember that he said that he couldn't swim over there? That guy that was over there on that island? Man, I hope he made it out safe. Because that island is completely flooded out as well. So you can talk to a load of these villagers here, and yeah... What? Did you say where are the cameras? What does he think? I'm some sort of reporter or something like that? Anyway, once you go into here, or Corona Mountain, I'll show you where Corona Mountain is in just a sec here. You go up to this area here. If you go on top of these umbrellas, I believe you can use these umbrellas to spring you up there, actually. Yeah, that's a pretty handy way there, and... What's this lady have to say about this situation? It sure is brighter. Have her shine. Don't you care about the flood, woman? People are drowning! Anyway, you go up here, there's Shadow Mario waiting for us. Now, I'm not going to do Corona Mountain just yet. So what I'm going to do here is go inside Corona Mountain and then exit the place, but I'm going to cut forward so you don't see Corona Mountain. And then I'm going to show you the next glitch on how to go underwater without those logs floating in the flood. So here we go. Going to Corona Mountain already. And the place is back to normal. Magically! It's like the whole tide receded in less than 5 seconds. Huh. Anyway, to activate that, you know, to walk underwater glitch, now what you have to do is go over to this gate over here by the Shine Sprite gate and try and swim your way underneath here, and there you go. You just kind of cheated the water system again. So now you're walking underwater once again. Now, it's not as cool as when it's flooded, because you know when it's flooded, it's a lot higher and you can't jump yourself out like you could do right there. But you can still activate that glitch anytime you want to. But the flood can only be done one time per game, unless you, like, use a, I don't know, action replay code or something like that. Anyway, I'm gonna end off the part here, and I'm gonna start more of the shines, or I should say, do more of the shines in Pianta Village in the next part. So I hope you enjoyed these glitches, as well as the shines themselves, and I'll see you later.